Thank you, President. Colleagues, allow me to present you a few facts. This year only, in January, Stanislav Markelov, the human rights lawyer who represented the assassinated journalist Anna Politkovskaya, was gunned down in the middle of the afternoon in downtown Moscow. On the same occasion, Anastasia Barburova, a journalist who tried to protect him, was also shot and died. In July, Natalia Istemirova, a well-known Russian human rights activist and journalist, was found dead in Ingushetia after being abducted by armed men in neighboring Chechnya. Less than a month later, another non-governmental activist, Zarema Sudareva, and her husband were abducted and killed. In August, journalist Abdul Malik Ahmadilov was shot dead shortly after leaving his home in Dagestan. Six outstanding journalists and human rights activists died in less than 8 months. These abductions and murders are only the peak of what means the deterioration of human rights situation in Russia, where independent voices, including lawyers, journalists and other activists, face increasing violence, threat and unjustified prosecution. Human rights violations in Russia, and especially in North Caucasus, can no longer be ignored. We cannot be that naive and believe that the super powerful Russia, with one of the strongest intelligence services in the world, is not capable to find the perpetrators and bring them to justice. We all, regardless of our political color, have to understand that impunity for attacks against human rights defenders will contribute to more violence and a growing culture of lawlessness. Russian authorities must ensure the physical safety and freedom of movement and expression of human rights defenders in accordance with the United Nations Declaration of Human Rights Defenders.